This tutorial will cover creating an assignment in Blackboard 9. Creating an assignment will allow you as a faculty member to get files such as papers or other documents from students. So in this tutorial we'll cover adding assignments, we'll talk about student submissions, and then retrieving those submissions. So the first thing we're going to do is go to the assignment area in Blackboard. You can also do this in other content areas. And we're going to click on Create Assessment, and if you go down, you'll see Assignment. Now you want to give this assignment a name, for instance, Paper. And you can give instructions, for instance, only submit Word documents or rich text format, or whatever you're comfortable with. You can also attach a file that will give instructions on the assignment. And then you'll want to put possible points in, because this will automatically create a gradebook item where you'll retrieve the documents afterwards. I want to make this assignment available. Availability also includes the number of attempts, so you can allow a single attempt, unlimited attempts, or you can limit it to two or three depending if you want rough drafts. You can also limit how long this assignment is available to students by clicking here and putting in the due dates, because after that due date it will no longer be available to students. Then you hit Submit, and you'll see this assignment shows up now in the assessment area. Now, if I go to a student view, and I click on Assignments, you'll see now they will see this paper, and when I click on this, it gives the ability for the student to leave some comments if they'd like, and they need to browse their computer and find a file. So I have student paper here. I'll choose that and I'll hit submit. You'll notice that this gives a submission history for each student. Now when I go back to the faculty site, to retrieve this paper or these submissions, I need to go to the Grade Center. I'm going to click on Full Grade Center. And you'll notice there's an exclamation point where this test student, has submitted their paper. Now, I can individually click here and look at the attempts. And you'll notice that there is the file attached, and I could click on that. I could assign my points and give feedback. I could also browse my computer and attach a file with comments on it. And I'd hit Save and Next. Another way of retrieving the documents is up at the top of the column. If you click, you'll notice that there is a assignment file download. And what this allows you to do is, if I had numerous students in this course, I could click on this tab right here. And when I hit submit, it will actually produce a zip file that I can download to my computer so I can look at all the files at once and grade them, and then come back and put the grades in. So if I was offline, I might want to do that. So we've covered adding assignments, looking at student submissions, and retrieving those submissions. Thank you for watching this tutorial.